Magandang araw po at magandang gabi sa mga nakakapanood sa gabi at sa lahat ng mga nakakapanood nitong video na ito. Ngayon po ay bigyan po natin ng kaunting komento itong video na ito na nakikita nyo sa screen. Ito po yung bagong sandatang nabili, no? Nabili ng Pilipinas na acquire. Siguro iba, yung iba pong tagapanood natin dito ay napanood na ito, na lumabas ito sa ibang YouTube channel. So dito, tingnan po natin yung kapasidad nito bilang isang depensa. So sa tingin ko, hindi lang sa pang-depensa magagamit ito, no? Pang-offense magagamit, pero kung mas maganda kung wag nang magamit, ano, magamit lang sa panakot, pero wag nang magamit ng aktwal sa isang digmaan. Sige po, tingnan po natin itong unit na ito na nabili ng Pilipinas. So iyan po yung barko, no? Kung makikita mo doon sa bilog, doon siya nakakabit. Doon siya nakakabit sa yung binilugan na yon. Ito yung barko na binili ng Pilipinas, nakasama na itong unit na ito na pang-depensa, no? Yung armaments. So, yung demo niyan, kung mapapansin nyo, talagang modern po yung itsura. Ito po yung kanyang demo.
The close-in weapon system on warships, commonly known as the Close-In Weapon System, CIWS, is one of the must-have complementary weapons. Goped in a CIWS made by Aselsan,
masasabi nating uubra.
The company said that many countries in the Asia-Pacific region have paid attention to this weapon. Goped in is one of the mainstay products offered by Aselsan for the export market. Aselsan raised over $2 billion United States dollars in its new business and has balance orders of $8.5 billion by the end of 2021. The leading Turkish defense company successfully added 6 new countries to its customer list that year. Aselsan has now received export orders.
Ang tanong, gaano kaya karaming bala ang uubusin nito bago matarget yung isang dapat na matarget o targetin, ano?
Aselsan has succeeded in attracting 15 new countries to its list of export customers. Regarding the Gokden CIWS, this system has been selected by Turkmenistan to equip its largest warship.
At kada bullet o bala nito, magkano kaya yung masasayang kung walang tatamaan? At kung gaano karaming bala?
In addition to the Turkmenistan Denizhan, the Pakistan Navy's Babur-class multi-mission corvette, Milgum, will also be equipped with the Gokdeniz. While in Turkey itself, the Gokdeniz CIWS
mukha namang accurate ang class frigates of the armaments Navy. Na ito.
This is the second phase of the Milgum program, which will produce 4 warships. Aselsan has tested the Gokdeniz prototype on a Turkish Navy ship in May 2018. As the target of the Gokdeniz shooting are target drones flying at high speeds exceeding 180 meters per second. This CIWS can engage low-flying targets and offers autonomous long-range target detection, tracking, and firing. The system's automatic linkless feed mechanism allows for simultaneous loading of HEI and airburst ammunition and switching between ammunition types as needed. In addition to anti-ship missiles, Gokdeniz is also effective against helicopters, fighter aircraft, unmanned aerial vehicles, drones, and other asymmetric surface threats. As Aselsan stated, Gokdeniz was able to operate effectively at sea conditions up to level 5 due to its stable gun turret. This weapon system offers automatic target tracking with an integrated tracking platform, including a tracking radar and electro-optical EO sensor. An optional 3D search radar is also available. Gokdeniz, together with the 35mm airburst atom ammunition, was developed by Aselsan as a CIWS weapon system that is highly effective against anti-ship missiles. The 5mm Atom ammunition was developed jointly with MKEK and Tubatak Sage with Aselsyn as the prime contractor.
Close-in Weapon System, or CIWS in short, is a point defense weapon system used to detect and destroy incoming short-range missiles and enemy aircraft that have breached the outer defenses. It is typically mounted shipboard in a naval capacity, and these devices are installed on nearly all classes of larger modern warships. CIWS are also used on land to protect military bases. In today's video, we give you the 10 close-in weapon systems today, and we will rank them based on rate of fire. Rheinmetall Oerlikon Millennium Gun. Originated from Switzerland, the weapon is designed to be controlled by an external fire control system using either radar or electro-optical trackers. In an anti-surface role, the Millennium Gun is a fast and powerful effector, while in an anti-air role, the Millennium Gun can engage a large spectrum of air threats ranging from low radar cross-section anti-ship missiles to fast attack aircraft and helicopters. The Millennium Gun can also defeat challenging low, slow, and small air threats posed by unmanned aerial vehicle. It can fire an effective range of up to 5,000 meters at 1,000 rounds per minute. Danel 35mm Dual Purpose Gun. The 35 DPG is a close-in weapon system for warships built in South Africa and is currently in service in the Valor-class frigates of the South African Navy. Its primary role is to defend against attack by helicopters, fixed-wing aircraft, and missiles. It also has a secondary role against surface vessels and shore targets, both in symmetrical and asymmetrical warfare, and also in law enforcement, where accuracy is critical because collateral damage is unacceptable. The effective firing range is about 4,000 meters, and the rate of fire from each barrel is 550. The Marroca CIWS is a Spanish Navy 12-barrel 20mm Oerlikon gun mounted in two rows of six guns each. The system's primary purpose is defense against anti-ship missiles and other precision-guided weapons.
So masasabi ko ay talagang mukhang epektibo ito at mukhang mahirap iwasan, ano? Lalo't kung yung airplano mo mabagal, oh, yung mga jet fighter mo, at kung accurate ito, mukhang kayang-kaya kang salubungin at pabagsakin ito. Pero sinasabi ko nga, sana ho ay hindi na ito magamit sa aktwal na labanan, ano? Sana umurong na yung isa't isa, makita lang ito para wala nang labanan. Kasi po lahat naman po nang nasasangkot sa gera ay talunan, at yung both side, alam natin na may masasaktan doon pag may namatay. Ganun din naman sa atin, yung mga sundalo natin, pag may nabawasan tayo at namatayan, masasaktan yung pamilya noon. Ganun din doon sa kalaban. So, both side talo. Sana hanggang panakot na lang ito at hindi na mag-materialize pa yung tinatawag nating gera o labanan. So, sana po may napulot kayong kaunting aral dito sa video na ito. Kahit kaunti lang po. So, sana pagpilikin niyo po itong mga video natin dito, at maraming salamat po sa patuloy na pagsuporta sa channel na ito. Hanggang sa muli po, ito po ang Avoy Mix Videos.